on the budget 2018 general assumptions, but postponed their decisions on those assumptions pending the outcome of the OPEC meeting in Vienna. We have those decisions already from OPEC. Now we expect the legislators to go back into their rooms on the floor and begin to decide on what will be the peg for the total output for 2018 and what the benchmark price will be for crude oil for 2018 fiscal appropriations. Last Thursday, as the senators were ramping up, Majority Leader Hamad Lawan told his colleagues, that was partly quoted, that it is important that we wait, that's the legislators, and see the outcome of the OPEC meeting regarding production quota. That will determine what will be the benchmark ultimately. Now we have that. Now the ball has been thrown back into the hall of the, into the field of the legislators, and both the upper and the lower house. We expect to be a very interesting conversations there in Abuja all this week, and you can expect to hear all of that here on Channels Television. In the meantime, today, it's 10 years since we, this FSS 2020 was formally inaugurated in the manner of speaking. Nigeria's Central Bank Governor, Godwin Emefiele, is expected today to speak at the 10th anniversary of the Financial System Strategy 2020 at a forum here in Lagos. The idea was to strategize on how to implement the framework put together back then in 2004 under Professor Chukwuma Soludo's central bank leadership. It was Chukwuma Soludo back then who designed that, what called the FSS 2020. It was a grand plan by the central bank to make Nigeria Africa's financial gateway by the year 2020. And the idea was to rival Johannesburg as South Africa as the destination or the gateway for financial services in Africa. That was the grand ambitious plan of Chukwuma Soludo then, who was the governor of the central bank. A part of the plan back then, if you were in the know, with that document more than 200 pages publicly displayed, was to build a Lekki financial city. Well, a financial corridor, as it were. And that was downtown, across to the ocean, Lagos South. Just to imitate the Dubai Financial Center. That was what that document says in 2004. But many years down the line, we're yet to see the FSS 2020 actually take off. And the deadline or the expiry date is just 3 years from now. So there's a forum today in Lagos between the central bank and other stakeholders within the financial services industry to see how to get FSS 2020 to still birth and deliver safe and sound by the year 2020. It's still pregnant, by the way. Okay, so we have the FGN savings bond for December. This is the last auction by the debt office. The patient's only house DMO will be today offering two tenured Naira papers for retail investors in the market. The first is a two-year paper due December 13, 2019 at 11.738% per annum coupon. That's what you get if you buy into that bond. If you buy the three-year paper maturing December the 13th, year 2020, you get 12.738% per annum on your money, on your investment. While you get your main investment back, the government will add 12.738% on top of your money, even if you buy as low as 5,000 naira, which is the minimum, or if you have 50 million naira to buy as the maximum subscription. That's what happens. Then what else is there on our calendar for this month? We have a few more as we finish off the year. Lafarge, Nigeria's second largest cement company, issuing almost 4 billion rights issues, which is called ordinary shares. That is expected to wrap up on the 15th. One of the major shareholders of offerings of 2017 market year. We have a few others so far this year. And the market has resumed today for full business and trading week. We'll be digesting 7-Up market offering the announcement made late last week that the majority shareholder, the Afleka, who owns 73.2% of 7-Up, plans to buy out minority shareholders in Nigeria, looking to reshape the bottler's dented financial position. Okay, we'll have a look. Let's just quick throw in the stock market. It was a very bullish week. 4 days last week, 14.257 billion ordinary shares. We crossed the 37,000. We almost made 38,000. And you can see the numbers there. Flip that over. Look at the total volume for the week. 14 billion fetched us 35 billion on the equity capitalization for nearly for about 17,000 transactions. And if you take the five sector performances, you'll see that the big boys, all the five sectors were in the green, led by the insurance, followed by the banks. That's their cousin. We'll talk about the banks much later on the program in 2017. We're banking on the banking stocks. That's what we call it. The consumer goods brought 1.32% to the table. The industrials, 1.15. Lafarge's shares will be a bit of an suspension paid in the time. This right offer is concluded on the 15th. So CCNN was making very large, was making good gains on that. Well, yeah, but correction there. Lafarge was also making gains. That was on Thursday. Dangote Cement made a gain. CCNN, that's a cement company of Northern Nigeria, also made a gain. 5% CCNN. Dangote Cement, 1.66%. Lafarge Africa, 1.63%. And then we saw that rally in Forte Oil making a very strong comeback, 1.37%, pushing that sector to 1.3% gain for the, well, capping up the entire month of November. At the NASD, what you call the over-the-counter market, and see that of a butchering, if you call it, the blood on the street of the NASD, 2.86% haircut, shaving the unlisted securities index below the 600 a psychological level, and then you find the market cap there. But if you look at the volume, that's also significantly lower, 33.09% Friday trade, or Thursday trade, I beg your pardon, as a public holiday Friday, Thursday that was. 8.05 million naira in 20 transactions. Two of the bellwethers in a very small market give the market a very sharp haircut that you saw, 2.86%. WAMCO, the milk maker, was down 6.04%. We believe that was much of bargain hunting and some profit taking. Then CSCS was down 8.48%. We'll be back after the break. Then we'll look at the budget right now. In the water.